Revelation chapter 9. Revelation chapter 9. Susan and I are going to take a little vacation starting this week, so we'll take off today. We'll take a little break. Praise the Lord for Brother Joshua and Brother Andrew. They'll be filling the pulpit, and you'll be blessed by their preaching. People keep asking for me to go on my vacation. Somebody said, I don't know if you said this, you're taking a staycation.
Where the Garden of Eden was between the Tigris and the Euphrates River.
chapter, along with the river Euphrates, and the first came from the river Euphrates. The first man created, first woman created, first family created there. The first sin, the first murder was there. The first apostasy, rebellion against the word of God occurred there. All kinds of things. The ancient city, Babylon, sprung to life along the banks of this river. And you remember Babylon as the birthplace of false religion. And then the demon worship and idolatry, many of the false religions you can trace right back to Babylon. And that area is still an area that the world is focused on, right along with Israel. It's focused there in that region. And then you notice that they've been allowed, they've been released for a specific period of time. Look at verse 15, four angels were released, which were prepared, and look how specific, which were prepared for an hour, and a day, and a month, and a year, for to slay the third part of men. I want to help you to understand this. God always has a plan. Okay? You don't catch God by surprise. God is not, he doesn't ever wring his hands and say, I didn't see that come. But what am I going to do now? See, he already has a plan. He has a plan ahead of time. And it's always, let me say this, it's a perfect plan. Even when sometimes we go through some hard times, God has a plan. And he has a perfect plan. He has perfect timing. And such is the case here. You see, Satan wants to destroy, and God wants to give life. Satan, I put this in your notes, Satan is sinister, but write this down. God is sovereign. Very important. God's in control. Things can be spiraling out of control in the United States of America, Washington, the country around the world. God's in control. Amen. He's in control.
Third
faith. And so you have that. So many people are being put to death. Now, understand this. Angels have power. They have power. I think you might hear that. Demonic angels, the fallen angels, they also have power. And you've got these holy angels and these unholy angels warring against each other. The Bible says we resign against flesh and blood. We have principalities against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world. So I believe this, I said this, actually, we've got angels and we've got demons all around us. Are you believing that? And they're warring, and there's a war going on. And Satan is warring, and he's trying to destroy them. You know the word principalities that's in that verse, the result of his because principalities, the word means fine. Jesus, chief demons, ruling demons, who rule in the darkness of this world. That's who that is, that they're around, they want to destroy them. So this dark time is a demonic time. Number two, this dark time is a destructive time. It's a destructive time. Verse 16 says the number of the army of the horsemen were 200,000, and I put the number of them and the first of the horses in the vision. And then that saw them having as pipes of fire and Jason comes down and heads of the heads of the horses were as the heads of lions. Out of their mouth, out of their mouth issued fire and smoke and brimstone. By these three was the third part of men killed by the fire and by the smoke and by the brimstone which issued out of their mouths. For the tongue is in their mouth and in their tails. For the tails were like serpents and their heads, and with them they do. So these four demons released the mission of the Panther, and they ate that vast army, 200 million. Someone has done this research here and said if you were to line them up in formation 1 mile wide, they would stretch 87 miles long. You can imagine 200 million. China boasts several years ago that they have an army that had put together an army of 200 million. Now they used that term to say that they had 200 million. And when they said it, people said, there it is. There's the prophecy. They said that China has 200 million. Of course, years ago, that certainly wouldn't have been the case, but there's 200 million that they had put together. But you know what? We know for sure this is these are humans. Well, no, could these be humans? Maybe. Could they be demons? Maybe. Could they be humans that are possessed by demons? Perhaps. We don't know. When you look at some of the horrible things that are going to happen, some people would say these are. John's seeing things going on that is modern-day military things like tanks and rockets and helicopters and missiles and stuff. Because John didn't see any of those things. And maybe that's what these trying to describe the aircraft and the missiles in the air and the fire and all that. It could be. Could just simply be demonic demons, just like the kind of a demon. Here's what you do, guys. And it would be foolish to be too dogmatic about this, about exactly what this is. But it would also be really foolish to not think this is bad. It's going to be horrible. It's going to be painful. They're going to come through with destruction and death. And it's certainly demonic activity. We know that. Those angels, those fallen angels have been bound and they're loosed. Maybe they're the worst of the very worst, and they've been released. So this dark time is a destructive time. Thing number three. This dark time is a depraved time. to verse 20. And the rest of the men were not killed by these plagues. Yet they did none of the works of their hands, that they should not worship temples and temples of gold and silver and brass and stone and wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither did they have their murderers, nor their sorceries, nor their fornication, nor their things. So, we're told one third of all the people on earth will be killed. And you would think that with this destruction and death, you would think surely people would repent. They've gone through 5 months of horrible pain. And now they're seeing people drop, a third of people drop again. And you would think they would repent, but they won't. They will not repent. You know what this is? It's like an X-ray. You see the hearts of men, that's what you're seeing, no matter what happens. They're dark. Their dark hearts will not repent. Repent, the word is menuelo. And it means, and by the way, this word, this term, is in Revelation. Repent more than any other book of the Bible. It's the heartbeat of God that men repent and turn to Jesus Christ. And so he puts himself in the last days that men should repent. But here he says that they won't. Menuelo means to change. Meta means change. Nuelo means your mind or your will or your heart. And they will not, no matter what's going on, they will not change their mind. They will not change their heart. They refuse to. They will not repent. It's unbelievable. Man is a religious creature. You can travel anywhere in this world, and you're going to see religion. Anywhere, everywhere, you're going to see religion. The majority of it's going to be false religion. And they always need to be doing what we just read about. They're going to be worshiping gold and silver and brass and stone and wood and idols and so forth and so on. But you may find religion. But during the tribulation period, they're going to be worshiping demons. The attempt. You're going to see this more and more. There's an increase even in America. You see it in movies. You see it in television shows. You see it in papers and books and magazines. You see an increase in the occult and Satanism and technology. And people want to sit in daily the games. The kids are playing. See it. Brother Andrew has been passing out some vacation Bible school flyers. We have them up there. I'm trying to encourage you to take some days into some neighbors. Let them know we have vacation Bible school. But he's been going door to door passing out vacation Bible school flyers. And why would you do that? Is it just so we can say we have a lot of numbers? No. The reason is because we want to reach the lost. We want to reach the people. We want to reach the children. We want to reach parents. We want to reach families in the area. We want to tell the good news. To live the day without Christ and go to heaven. And heaven sees forgiven. That's why we do things we do. Right? But as he's passing out those vacation Bible school flyers to try to tell the good news, there's others passing out flyers this weekend out of California. And I believe my copy of this is the Satanic Temple After School Satan Club. And we see a lot of this for kids. And what you notice is, let's have fun at After School Satan Club. Science projects, classes, games, arts and crafts, nature activities. Kids, your children will learn benevolence, empathy, critical thinking, problem solving, creative expression. And then listen to this one. Personal sovereignty. You know what that is? Meditation, that's what they're wanting. this New Age stuff, this religion. This is the Jane Addams Elementary After School Satan Club. They're going to take all children grades first through fifth, regardless of religious background. And it's a permission slip for this, it's a permission slip. Just like we would do, perhaps, to go to campus at the Institute of Permission Slip. If my child has permission to attend the after school Satan Club, this to be signed by the parents of such and such a time, and how they will sign this, is letting Satan and his demons not only babysit and entertain, but indoctrinate your child. That's what you really like. You say, well, yeah, that's really unusual. No, it's not. He said, what I'm trying to show you is Satan is on the move. Satanism, demonology, the occult, these religions, they're on the move. I mean, let me show you a few little headlines, just a handful. 12-year-old Mississippi girl told police she helped her boyfriend dig up the body of a buried baby and lead her to that town in satanic rituals. Here's another one. This one gets on my bonus track. Deaths of human hands stolen from graves linked to satanic rituals. Here's one coming from Mexico. Detective warns of Satanism performing ritualistic mass murders. Here's another headline. Ryan, a woman new generation, is coming to Satanism. Here's another one. The rise of Satanism in America. Here's another one. Lucifer rising. Here's another one. The rise of the satanic temple. Here's another one. The rise of Satanism in Canada. So we could go on and on. There are hundreds of thousands of these witchcraft and weapon. It's just exploding your numbers than ever practicing witches and witchcraft right now. In the United States, not to mention in many other places in the world. But this mental torture to get the occult begins with entertainment. What was the headline in this thing I just read? Hey kids, let's have fun. Games, sports, fun. It begins with entertainment. Same thing with these games. It's entertainment. And kids are getting hooked on. It moves to enlightenment. See what it keeps you. Peaceful, sovereign, creative thinking, and so forth and so on. I'm going to teach you about gender things. You have been born a man, a boy, you can be a girl if you want to. You have been born a girl, but you can be a boy if you want to. So Satan is moving in these areas. Here it is. It starts with entertainment, it moves to enlightenment. It moves to the area of enslavement. That's what's sad. People get trapped in the system, unable to get free. And then you have something like Uvalde. What happens? The murder of innocent children. What is that? How could somebody get to the point that they would just mow down innocent children? And of course, this is again, it's not uncommon. We've seen this a number of times for the last few years at schools, at churches. These people just want to kill people. Just kill people. Let me tell you what I believe it is. I tell you. Just like that puzzle, just like everybody else. I can tell you what I believe. I believe this 100% Satanism. This kid, I don't know anything about it, but he's demon possessed. Or demon oppressed. He's demon controlled, influenced, Satanism. That's what it is. Because you can't make right reason out of this. Just like the people when Jesus went to the devil. There's this maniac of the devil. That doesn't make sense. This guy is growing into the tombs. That doesn't make sense. He's got chains and shackles, but he's so strong you can rip them off. Look at that. That makes no sense. No, because he was possessed by demons.
things that we don't see, things that we can't even understand. There is demons out there. They're real. People are playing around in settings to get here. With the games, with the movies, with the dark things. Parents, wake up. Know what your kids are watching. Know what your kids are eating. Please deliver them. Because this is starts with that. I mean, it's just fun. Watching those movies and those, it's just fun. It starts with entertainment. It moves to enlightenment. There was a witch in the Harry Potter series. She was a witch for years and years. She said, it's a lot of fun stuff. It's bad. I can show you every single thing this is a witch for years. Get away from it. The Bible says it this way. Abstain from what? All appearance of evil. Well, I'm not sure, but if all victim of evil, get away from it. Don't allow your children to be part of it. Because it starts with entertainment. It moves to enlightenment. But then it's entrapment. It's sitting in bondage. Oh, this is serious. Let's start that. It's a depraved time. You want to focus on it. There's four things he mentions here. The first one's murder. Murder. During these temples of commitment, there will be hitmen. There will be kill for profit. There will be serial killers. Kill for thrones. And again, he saw it, but he followed it. See, Satan is behind this. That's what's going to happen during the tribulation. People will not repent of murder. He just said, not to reject persons. People committing murder every day. Sacrifice on the altar of convenience. See, a little baby is not convenient for us right now. So it's like kill. It's like murder. Yes, it is. The baby's alive. Maybe I didn't build that. Baby's innocent. The baby's alive. You're protected by the laws of America. And your babies are separate from it. It's like convenience and personal life. They killed. All the concentration camps of Nazi Germany, but far more. The second thing they won't repent from is sorceries. It's the word pharmakia, where we get our term pharmacy. We're talking about mind altering drugs, and they're becoming more prevalent now, but they will reach pandemic proportions. Drugs. People will not repent and choose the drugs instead of Jesus Christ. The third thing, fornication. It's the Greek word, pornea. Pornea is where we get that term, pornography. Pornea. And people will not turn from it. Our society is already saturated with sex. Sexual perversion will increase and increase and increase. Can't get satisfied. It increases adultery, fornication, and it will be rampant, and people will not repent from immorality. And then the fourth one is interesting. All sins in our place. It's thefts. It's thefts. I mean, you put murder, fornication, sorceries. But see, thefts will increase the word personal wrath, personal properties on it. People just take it. Have you already seen anything like that? He got impeachment. He got his attacker. He got impeachment. And it's rioters go in and they just destroy it. And then they break it and steal. Steal is not theirs. Are you kidding me? We're already seeing it. Thefts. Where's the police? We're going to defund the police. We don't want them. Are you kidding me? Lawlessness will abound in the last days. We want to remove the law and remove the laws. And again, it reaches so much more than everything. This will continue to happen as food and water and medicine and clothing and shelter and gasoline become increasingly scarce. You're going to see more of this looting and thefts. Again, you see the shadows of all of these things already. We're not in the tribulation, folks. By the way, if you're saved, you won't be in the tribulation. Praise the Lord, you won't be here. The Lord's going to take the bride out. You'll be off the earth. Just make sure you're saved. You know, the Bible paints a bleak picture of the tribulation. Technology and humanity and violence. Unprecedented. But men will continue to harden their hearts more and more, and they will not repent. I want to close with this. I read about an evangelist. His name is Paul Rader. Paul Rader had been trying to witness to a particular man at his bank. And he had witnessed to him several times, but his banker would not get saved. He was one particular day, an evangelist, Paul Rader, just felt, I need to go back today to talk to this speaker one more time. I need to talk to him today. He just felt so unfolded this day. I said, this is what I believe I'm supposed to do today. So he did. He traveled across town. He went to the bank, and sure enough, when he got to the bank, there was the banker standing in the doorway. And he said, Paul Rader, come up the steps. He said, Paul Rader, how are you doing? He said, casually. He said, you know what? I've been thinking about following you. Paul Rader said, that's okay. God sent me over. He said, well, come in my office. And he went in and they talked. And sure enough, Paul Rader shared the gospel again. But this time, within an hour, this banker put his faith and trust in Jesus Christ got saved. Just a second or two after he got saved, he gave us this amazing test and fell in the arms of Paul Rader. Dead. I thought, what if Paul Rader had not gone? What if that Paul Spirit telling him, you need to go talk to this man? What if he had? What if he said, yeah, you know what? What if he had done that? What if this people said, you know, I'm getting closer. I'm getting closer, you know, but I'm not ready yet. What if he had said, I'm just going to wait. I'm going to wait a little longer to appreciate you God. You see what this man did? It's his last few minutes. It was his last few minutes on earth. His taking down to the last few seconds. He accepted Jesus as a Savior and died. Folks, you're not always that way, God. No different person there is not to your age. It matters not. You don't know how to sound your God. Nobody does. You're not close tomorrow. So how foolish would it be if I know I'm not truly saved and go with God, then I'm going to wait. As foolish as that. What we do here on earth can make a whole lot of sins. It doesn't really matter. But what we do for Christ is for eternity. If there's anybody here, you don't need Christ. It's not safe today. If sins are in your life, you're not doing it for God, get it back today. If you need to repent, come to Christ. Get that stand. Whether your head's bowed or eyes closed, if you need to make a decision,